Okay, I know that everyone who clicked on this video already knows how to tie a circle hook, but I hope that you have noticed that if I make a video on a very popular topic, I will try to introduce a new angle and show you something new. Otherwise, I wouldn't just make a video on a topic that already has 1,000 videos on YouTube. And today also, I'll try to show you a new way to think about tying circle hooks. And actually not just circle hooks, but all hooks, even though the title says circle hooks. There are a lot of videos in the catfish world showing you how to snare a circle hook. And they are always very careful to point that when you're done with the snaring part over here, you have to exit the eye like I'm showing you in this example here. You have to enter the eye from the back and exit from the front, so to have this slight angle over here. And the purpose of this angle is to create the so-called trigger effect. For the demonstration purposes of this video, I'm going to have my hooks tied with wire just because it's very easy to see. I did try to record the video using 50-pound mono. This is the thickest line I have, but as you can tell, it's clear and very difficult to see. I don't have any high-vis leaders, so we're gonna have to do with wire, but I think the wire looks good and it's very easy to see. The way this trigger effect works, the way they explain it, is this angle here between the exiting line and the shank of the hook is causing the hook to rotate when you pull the line. See, you're pulling the line and the hook is rotating like this and the tip is moving forward and it's grabbing the fish. And if you don't tie the hook like this, so you have the angle here, like in this case here, when somebody pulls the line, you're just pulling the hook forward and you don't catch as many fish as with the trigger effect. And every time you hear them say trigger effect, you can tell from their body language and from their voice that they feel some incredible satisfaction because it makes them feel like they're using, you know, engineering terminology. And everybody feels good when they use engineering terminology. And I think this is the reason why this explanation of this trigger effect is just so uniformly accepted. It's because it just sounds so engineering and it sounds so nice. Unfortunately, this trigger effect is complete engineering nonsense, and there are two reasons for that. The first reason is that this is not how the hook will rotate in the mouth of the fish. When they demonstrate you this trigger effect on camera, actually they are the one rotating the line and the hook with it. They're not pulling the line, but when they're demonstrating, they're just rotating it. But that's not what's happening in the mouth of the fish. Let's see what happens when you only pull the line instead of rotating it. I know this is clear line, but I hope you can still see it. And I have tied it the correct way so to have trigger effect. Lots of angle here, should be easy to see which way the hook is rotating. And I'm gonna just pull the line and I'm gonna hold the hook like this over here so you guys can see what's happening. So pay close attention which way is the hook rotating, okay? I'm starting to pull, I'm pulling, it's rotating, it's starting to rotate, pulling. And it's done rotating. So actually, do you see? When you pull the line, the hook is actually rotating in opposite direction of what they're describing. So according to their own logic, this would actually make it more difficult to catch the fish. That's the first reason why this trigger effect doesn't do nothing. The second reason why the trigger effect doesn't work is because it doesn't even matter which way the hook is rotating in the mouth of the fish. Doesn't matter if it's rotating this way or that way. The circle hook is not designed to rotate when you pull the line. The circle hook is designed to travel first, okay? If the hook is in the mouth of the fish, it has to travel from the mouth of the fish to the lip of the fish, and then it will go around the lip and it will grab the lip. If the circle hook is all the way in the stomach of the fish, it can travel 8, 10, maybe 12 inches, depending on the size of the catfish. It can travel a long distance, go to the lip, and then it will go around the lip and it will grab the lip. This is how the circle hook is designed to work. So, first of all, the way they explain it turns this way, that's not how it turns, it actually rotates the other way. And second of all, it doesn't even matter how it rotates because it's not gonna catch the fish in the mouth. It has to travel to the lip and catch the fish at the lip. Now, imagine that these two hooks here are sitting in the mouth of the fish. And the end of this line here is the end of the mouth of the fish. So this point here is the lip of the fish. So to catch the fish, both hooks need to travel first until they reach the lip, and then they need to go around the lip and they need to catch the fish like so. The tip of the hook must be pointing towards the lip of the fish, right? If the tip of the hook is pointing away, it can slip and you're not gonna catch the fish. So let's put the position of the hook over here, the position where you're actually catching the fish, and compare the starting position of the two hooks. Now, because this hook has an angle here, when you start pulling the line, the line will always have the same angle when you are pulling the line. But this hook here will be straight, and the trigger effect hook is on an angle because of the angle that you created. Now, for this hook to rotate up to this position, it actually needs to rotate a few degrees more than this hook. Then, depending on how you're pulling the line, if you don't have enough angle, it can so happen that you will catch the fish with the black line here, with the black wire, but the red wire will slip just because when you reach the end of the mouth, the hook will be turned, the tip of the hook will be turned away from the lip. It really matters right now which way you're pulling the line, doesn't it? If you are pulling the line this way, then the hook will go around and it will grab. But if you are pulling the line this way, just away from the fish, then the hook will just slip. And you will reach a critical point, maybe right around over here, where the black wire would catch the fish, but the red wire will slip out of the mouth. So this trigger effect is not only not helping you catch more fish, but theoretically it's actually reducing your hookup ratio a little bit. Okay, how should you tie your circle hooks then to maximize the hookup percent? Well, it's very simple. Just avoid the trigger effect. In other words, make sure the line is coming out of your hook straight. There is no angle between the shank of the hook here and the line. The line needs to be like an extension of the shank of the hook. Just the whole thing, the hook and the line should form a straight line. That means you have no trigger effects. That means you have the maximum hookup percent that your hook allows. Okay, but how do you do that? Well, if you have a hook with a straight eye like this, you're not going to be able to snell this hook and have the line come out of the hook straight. It doesn't matter if you go from the back of the hook or from the front of the hook. The line is never going to be straight and you're going to have some trigger effect like in this example over here. You're always going to have crooked line. So when you have these hooks here with the straight eye, the way to tie them is to use a uni knot or Palomar knot or any of these knots that tie the hook on top of the eye. This way you don't have to exit through the eye on an angle, through the straight eye on an angle, and you're not gonna have crooked line and you're gonna have straight line. So if you're used to, if you like snell knots and you are used to snelling your hooks and you just want to snell your circle hooks, then I recommend instead of using circle hooks with straight eye, use a circle hook with a bent eye. Notice how on a bent eye hook, when you go from the back of the eye to the front of the eye, you're going up in almost a straight line from the shank of the hook. And as a matter of fact, when the line bends a little bit from the weight of the hook and the weight of the bait, the line will be coming out of the shank in completely straight line. This can never happen with a straight eye hook because going from the back of the eye to the front of the eye, I mean, look at the direction, it's almost completely perpendicular to the shank of the hook. And then the line is gonna bend a little bit from the weight, but you're still gonna be left with some angle here. That's why if your preferred method of tying the circle hook is some kind of snell, I recommend getting you some circle hooks with a bent eye. So when you're done with the snell, you go from the back of the eye to the front of the eye and you have a straight line coming out of the shank of the hook. Next time you shop for hooks and you see some hooks that are pre-snelled from the manufacturer, make a note of the eye of the hook. You're gonna see that pre-snelled hooks always, always come with a bent eye hook, just so the line can come out of the hook in a straight line. And vice versa, if your preferred method of tying the hook is Palomar knot or Uni knot or any of these knots that make the knot above the eye of the hook, just get a circle hook with a straight eye and you will be golden. So in these four examples that we have on the table here, this example is correct because we have a straight eye hook tied with a uni knot, and this example is also correct because we have a bent eye hook tied with a snell knot. This example is wrong because we have straight eye hook with a snell, and this example is also wrong because we have a bent eye with a uni knot. Now in reality, it's not the end of the world if you use, you know, one of this scenario or this scenario. Obviously people, you can see on YouTube, people use, you know, this kind of knot and they catch plenty of fish. So it's not the end of the world, probably only a few percent difference. But still, if you want to maximize your hookup percent, straight line is the way to go. And I actually think that if it wasn't for the YouTube experts, this is how people would tie their hooks if left on their own. Because, you know, having the line come out of the hook straight just intuitively feels right. And most people would tie it like this anyway. But there come the YouTube experts again and show you the people these trigger effects and all of the fancy stuff. And everything gets confused. But that's all I have for this video. Thank you for watching. I'll see you soon. Bye-bye.